SOCKS5 proxies, UDP network, SSL encryption? Wanna know what it all means? Let's crack the code of proxy and network protocols. But first, what is a network protocol? A network protocol is a set of established rules that dictates how data is transmitted between devices. These protocols allow different devices to communicate with each other, even if their infrastructure varies. But beware, not all network protocols serve the same purpose. For example, network management protocols set rules for monitoring and maintaining the network. Some popular examples include SNMP and ICMP. Network communication protocols determine data transmission and formatting. Data can encompass many things: HTML documents, JSON files, images, music, script files, or your beloved memes in GIF formats. Some communication protocols include TCP, UDP, HTTP, and SOCKS. Finally, network security protocols like SSL and TLS use security measures such as encryption to protect the data you send. Since you're here, you probably care about proxy servers. So, the most relevant protocols for you are UDP, TCP, HTTP, HTTPS, and SOCKS5. Let's have a closer look at each and compare them. TCP is a reliable protocol. This means TCP sets a connection between the client and the server before transferring any data. When a connection confirmation is received, TCP allows data transmission. Fun fact, this process is called a three-way handshake. With TCP, all data is checked for errors, and if any packets are lost during the process, the protocol resends them. TCP also uses mechanisms like flow control to reduce data forwarding rates and ensure that no data is lost. This protocol is used when no data can go missing, like when browsing the web, sending emails, or transferring files. An alternative protocol is UDP. It's a less reliable protocol that allows for higher speeds and lower latency. Know that UDP is more prone to errors as it doesn't wait for confirmation that the connection has been established. For this reason, UDP is better for time-sensitive data transmission, such as DNS lookups, web scraping, video streaming, and online gaming. So, how is it related to proxies? HTTP, HTTPS, and SOCKS5 proxy protocols operate on top of TCP and UDP connections. To understand this connection, we need to look at the OSI model. The OSI model is a framework that divides the functions of a networking system into 7 distinct layers. Layer 4, known as the transport layer, is where TCP and UDP live. This layer is responsible for ensuring that data is delivered reliably with TCP or quickly with UDP. Layer 7, the application layer, is where protocols like HTTP, HTTPS, and SOCKS5 reside. This layer deals with how data is presented and interpreted by the user. HTTP, for instance, controls how web pages are loaded in your browser, and it depends on TCP to handle the actual data transmission. With that said, let's dive deeper into some key protocols. HTTP stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol. As a communication protocol, HTTP is the foundation of data exchange across websites. On a fundamental level, HTTP and HTTPS are pretty similar, with one key distinction: the S at the end of HTTPS, which stands for secure. This indicates that HTTPS supports encryption for the data being transmitted. But why is it important? Since HTTP sends your information in plain text, anyone can intercept your request midway and read what it says. For this reason, HTTPS has become the preferred protocol for web browsing. In fact, many websites enforce HTTPS to prevent vulnerabilities and may even refuse HTTP connections. The key strength of HTTP and HTTPS protocols is data caching. This protocol can interpret web data, it can identify and prevent repetitive requests. So, using an HTTP or HTTPS proxy will significantly reduce data consumption. Another popular communication protocol is SOCKS5. The protocol does not include encryption like HTTPS does. However, SOCKS can handle more traffic than HTTP, like web scraping, torrents, and video streaming. While neither SOCKS nor HTTP proxies offer built-in encryption, the updated version SOCKS5 can be combined with SSH for secure communication. Regarding application compatibility, SOCKS proxies are more flexible since they can operate on any port, making them harder to detect and block. This flexibility also allows SOCKS proxies to bypass geo-blocks and firewall restrictions more effectively than HTTP, which are easier to identify. By the way, when you hear SOCKS5, it's just the fifth version of the SOCKS protocol. This protocol-agnostic version allows them to handle both TCP and UDP traffic. Plus, it enables various authentication methods. I know there's a lot of information, so let's recap. There are three main network protocol types, but for proxies, you should pay attention to communication and transfer protocols. TCP networks favor data transmission accuracy over speed, whereas UDP does the opposite. HTTP and HTTPS proxies rely on TCP connections, whereas SOCKS supports both UDP and TCP connections. You should choose HTTP and HTTPS proxies if you're accessing websites and need data caching to save bandwidth. HTTPS proxies also are more secure because they encrypt your data. SOCKS proxies are generally faster and more flexible because they are compatible with both UDP and TCP connections and various other protocols. Do you still have any questions about proxy protocols? Leave them in the comments or watch this setup guide next. And I'll see you in another video.